Okay, so we are here in my car, a 2000 Toyota Avalon. Be getting some requests to get a little bit more of a detailed look. I'm going to do a full car tour at some point, but just a little look at my car wash setup for now. So basically, I get quite a few questions about this. All it is my Handycam. This is an HDR CX430V, which is hooked up to a little clip that goes on the passenger side sun visor. These things are really cheap to pick up on eBay or Amazon. This one's like $4, I think. And this one just points out the windshield the entire time I take the video. And it records the audio, too. And then I use the second handheld camera, either the TX100V or the TX20, to record the stuff that involves turning around or is a little bit harder to catch on camera. As for the rest of the car, it's in very good shape for its age. The biggest upgrade you'll see looking at the front is the new stereo that I put in last year. This enabled me to play music off of my phone. The cable runs out down here through this little compartment. And the neat thing is, down here in the like cigarette lighter and ashtray thing, it makes a perfect iPhone 5 holder, just sideways like that. So I can actually put like navigation on my phone and be able to see the screen while I'm driving, and with this, have the audio come through the car speakers. It's pretty cool stuff. Let's go ahead and start it up. Open the door so you can hear. And that's pretty much about that. I always loved this information screen up here. It was really futuristic back in 2000 when my mom first got the car. Probably the neatest thing is that it doesn't even have 60,000 miles on it yet. My mom barely used it. Most of those 59,580 miles are from me in the last 5 years, if you can believe that. I've always loved this car, from the day that we got it, and I still do. And the moonroof makes filming car washes even easier. Plus you got the automatic temperature control, leather seats. Interior is in pretty good shape. This is the only thing I've ever had to have reupholstered because the other one kind of split down the middle. Then of course there's a new JVC stereo. This thing, once I hook my phone in, can do all kinds of stuff. It's even Sirius XM capable, though I have not bothered paying for that or hooking up the little adapter that you need. Nicest thing is the hands-free calling feature. I probably use that more than anything. So, I'm off to visit a friend in South St. Louis, and I'm going to film a car wash on the way. It's a pretty cool drive down there, so I'll go ahead and get the dash cam rolling and show you some of the highlights of the trip on the way. Alright, so we're a little bit away from my apartment now on Forest Park Avenue, and you can see straight ahead of us the Arch. We're in a neighborhood called Midtown, which is where I live, just a short distance away from downtown. So right now what we're going to be doing is merging on to Interstate 64, known locally as Highway 40. You can see both of them on the sign up there. We're headed east. This is a pretty neat highway too. It's an old double-decker elevated highway that runs through downtown. And it's pretty quiet on a Sunday morning. It's probably the only time this thing is quiet. I had to get way over to the right because in just about a mile or two, we're going to be taking an exit on the right side of the road. Get a pretty good view of downtown up here. And now we're entering, or very close to entering, the double-decker section. We are on the elevated section. Comes the double-decker part right here. Now you see we're going to be getting off on here at
6th Street. If you notice up there, it actually is the last exit in Missouri. After this, the highway crosses over the river and you enter Illinois. So, this is your last chance. Right here. I don't know if you can see down to the right very well, but that's where a big area of the rail yard is. It gets even bigger when you go across the river. Got Busch Stadium coming up on the left, home of the St. Louis Cardinals, of course. And now it's time to exit the highway. And we're entering a neighborhood called Soulard. It's kind of funny, actually. This city was basically founded by the French, and then later taken over by Germans, Italians, pretty much everybody else. And over the course of the last 100 or 200 years, we've taken all the French names for things and started butchering them terribly, and that's the right way to pronounce them around here. It's just kind of a funny thing. So what we'll do now is come up here and take a left turn. You can see that tanker train up there. It's a very cool older part of town. The lights are actually working pretty well for us here. Take a right turn, past the White Castle, and now we're on our way into Soulard. This is kind of making me wish that I took a different route. Soulard's actually a very nice area, but I'm not really touching any of the nice parts in this drive. It's really more if you were to take a right turn here and go up and get into that area. It just looks like a really nice historic river town, basically, which is what it is. Get a little bit of a better feel for it as we turn up here. This is the historic Soulard Farmers Market over to our right. We just went by it. Almost forgot to even point it out. I'll tell you, I have literally caught every single red light on the street so far. It's incredible. By the way, if you look straight up ahead of us, you might see those big red letters on top of the building. That is the main Anheuser-Busch Brewery, home of Budweiser. This is definitely a beer town. So, up here on the right, our car wash awaits us. Oops, it's actually this one. Almost turned into the wrong gas station. Story of my life, I guess. Alright, it is October 5th. 2014, and I just got gas for $2.84 a gallon. This is the first time I've gotten gas for under $3 in recent memory, anyway. Wow, that's a deal you get with a car wash. It's $2.94 if you don't get the car wash. So, let's pull around and see what I got for my $8 car wash. What is this that we have here? There's no way. When I saw this old pay station, I was thinking Ryko R7B. What do we have here? Admittedly, I'm not that well versed in older Ryko car wash systems, but that looks like the thing you see on an R7B. So our code is 59243. Drive into wash now. Certainly looks vintage, out here anyway. So we have a Ryko Ultrasonic. Hmm. All the equipment is sitting right here in the bay. Car in park. Rearview mirror shot. I hear a pin drop in here. It's actually pretty cool. I could hear the compressor turn on in the back there. Now we're getting our triple foam. That was fast. It moves. This is our clear coat. And I guess that's our spot free rinse. I guess that's it for that. Well, to be honest, I'm not exactly sure what I stumbled onto there. I don't know that much about the Ultrasonic, but as soon as I saw that pay station, my heart kind of skipped a beat. Did I really just miss an R7B? Maybe? Guess I'll find out. Talk to some of my friends that are more well-informed about this type of thing than I am. Info will be in the description. Thanks again for watching, and I guess that's it. It's almost poetic, isn't it? Look what happened while I was parked at his house. Bird decided this would be a great place to, well, you know. Of course. Well, I guess you know what that means. If
few days, maybe a week from now, I'll be taking out the world's cleanest car yet again for another car wash. Guess that's it.